Welcome to another Make a Card Monday. This week I'm going to be making a portrait card, meaning it'll fold this way. And because it's against the grain of the cardstock, I'm going to need to score it. I picked this up a few days ago. It's the Martha Stewart Craft Scoring Board. Sorry you can't see it all on screen. But I haven't used it too much, but I really like it. It has this little area up here where you can read, you know, like for a standard size card, where you need to score and things like that. So I'm just going to slide this in here, and then all I have to do is, comes with a bone folder, so you can use, just come in right here and make my scoring mark at 5.5, and then it folds right in half. I really like this bone folder in particular because it's really thin, so it makes a really thin kind of scoring mark for your card. However, for folding, I don't like it as much, you know, because it feels like it's going to really dig into that fold. I actually prefer the Stampin' Up! One for that. Okay, so here's my card. I'm going to be using some supplies, some from Sassafras, some from Stampin' Up!, just kind of all over the place today. I've got these two strips of pattern paper, and both of these come from, let me see if I can find it, I already cut it out here, from the Sassafras Monstrosity 6x6 pad. And it's, let's see, this paper right here, and then also this paper right here. I just cut out one of the strips of letters. So I'm going to go ahead and adhere those to the card. I didn't cut them to 5.5 because I thought I would get them on the card and then trim them off so they were perfect. So I'm going to use my grid mat in order to get these on perfectly straight. Kind of noting that about halfway right there, and come over here, it looks about right. All right, and then I'm going to take this one, and I want to be sure to get both sides really well. Okay. Looks like this one needs a little more adhesive just right there. Okay. And just trim. I'm going to do some stamping. I haven't used the stamps in a long time. In fact, I don't know if I ever have. I think maybe I did once. I don't remember. But I'm going to use one of these stitching stamps. I always thought these stamps were really cute, and I keep forgetting to use them. So here we go. I think I'm going to use this one. I'm using an acrylic block from Stampin' Up! This is some of their new blocks. I really like the feel of it. It feels like they're wood blocks. Okay, I'm going to use some color blocks fluid chalk ink. It's going to do kind of a tone-on-tone effect. Okay, I'm going to open it like that. Slide this underneath through some scratch paper. Okay, now I'm just going to start assembling some things down here at the bottom. I have some flower buttons from Sassafras that I thought would be really fun. And I'm thinking I'll do this white one. And I'm not going to press it down yet. I'm going to just place it there while I figure out some other things I'm going to glue on there. I've got some of these brads that I've had hanging around forever. I've just never used them. So I thought, why not? Maybe I'll do a red one. I'm going to do a little bit of stamping. I'm thinking I want a heart. So I'm going to use Stampin' Up!'s I Heart Hearts stamp set. I used this last week. You know, I thought, you know, I might as well use it again this week. I want to get most use out of it as I can. Let's see, is that big enough? New. What about this even bigger one? Okay. So I've got that on there. I think I want a green heart. I'm going to use some of Hewer Art's Hewer Hughes chalk ink. I haven't opened this one yet. But it's in a nice green color, nice and juicy. I'll have to swap out that button for a different color. Maybe a red button? These are from Basic Grays Lime Rookie Collection. Oh yeah, that'll be perfect. This is my other pack of Sassafras Brads that I've been meaning to use for ages. I think maybe we'll use this giraffe. I'm just making kind of like a sporadic arrangement of little embellishments. Let's see. I think I'll also cut out this little heart. And I think I'll cut out one of the other patterns in that paper pad. There we go, that's the spot right there. And I'll put the dimensional on that. Okay, now I'm going to do the sentiment, and I have this letter sticker set from Basic Gray, and these are little itty bitty letters, so I'm going to try to place them without getting them stuck everywhere, but we'll see. I think I'm going to have it say, maybe thinking of you. So I've always been hesitant to use letter stickers on cards because they're so big, but these are itty bitty. Alright, and I don't like how this spacing works right here, so I think I might just draw a little design element with my white gel pen. Maybe I'll just draw a little dashed line. Oh, hello. I guess I'm going to write it right there. Dashed line with an arrow or something like that. I drew some more other little hearts on here. Okay, so I think that does the card, except for a little bit of corner rounding. And I think maybe, yeah, I'll do both. Okay, so there is this week's card. Really different for me, kind of all over the place, a little bit eclectic. So hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll catch you guys next week. Thanks for watching.